it is for a couple seconds of joy, and one misplaced spark can cause devastation, the likes of which even the gods have never seen. So quit your fussing.
Yeah,
really.
Take your kids to the zoo. Take your kids to the aquarium. There's like a million things you can do to celebrate the 4th of July that doesn't involve blowing shit up.
Exactly. You know, bake an apple pie.
Yeah.
Bake a cherry pie. Have a barbecue.
Have a kazoo contest.
Have a laughing, belching, and farting contest. Have some beer at home and just get drunk at home. Oh yeah, one other thing too. Well, actually, no, I'll just say that for at the end of the show. Actually, because that would be a fun. The second smallest violin award goes to. It's going to Michelle Bachman's husband, Dr. Marcus Bachman. This award is just for you.
Mr. Batshit Crazy.
Shame on you for calling any specific group of people barbarians. How dare you? How dare you? That was really rude and very uncalled for. And I myself would like an apology. Because of the fact, not necessarily the definition of the word, that's irrelevant. I realize that now. And yes, I did post something on Facebook recently about that. And somebody who shall not be named actually thought that Dr. Bachman was right, and I wasn't too happy with that response. But anyways, that's irrelevant. The meaning of the word is irrelevant. It is what you said that matters. And you have a lot of people up in arms against you. And to call a specific group of people, whether they be LGBT, whether they be another race or ethnicity, creed, religion, whatever, to target a specific group of people, regardless of what was just mentioned.
And call them barbarians?
Call them barbarians? Shame on you!
We're calling you out!
Yeah, we are calling you out. Shame on you! Bad dog!
No cookie! Bad dog!
Bad doggy. Maybe we should call that the bad dog.
I like it.
Yeah, okay, so you know what? Instead of getting...
Bad
dog! Instead of the world's smallest violin award, we'll call that the bad dog
award.
Bad dog! Very bad dog!
I could get a lunatic.
Give me the bad dog board because I keep on saying the word Oh, wait a minute. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you. And really, I'm truly sorry about that. But stop saying Snowy. Stop saying the word It's okay to just be yourself. You are a professional weirdo.
Thank you, right? You are a professional weirdo. Keep being weird, just be yourself, and don't worry about the camera!
Well, before I forget, we're gonna introduce the Queen to a concert next week.
What? They're going to have a concert? Introduce me to
the Queen?
Concert?
Yep, you're gonna like them.
Hello, carry on! Yeah, so instead of calling it the world's smallest violin, we're calling it
Bad Dog Award.
So, yeah. So, Dr. Marcus Bachman, Bad Dog.
Bad Dog.
Don't call people barbarians. That's bad.
It's ironic, too.
Yeah, it is. Considering that, well, you know.
Considering that they would let most people just, like, die in the street from lack of health care.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's very barbaric.
Very barbaric.
As a matter of fact, it's so ironic too. Those who claim to be all goodness and holiness and so pious are actually. is when in 1776, our founding fathers signed the Declaration of Independence. And so there's going to be celebrations. All right, great. That's awesome. Two very important announcements, right? Number one, I want to reiterate, here in our lovely state of New Mexico, let's keep it lovely by not setting off any fireworks. No fireworks.
No fireworks.
No fireworks.
None.
Not even the professionals are going to chance it this year.
Nope.
So there. Second, and very, very important, please, I know you're out there celebrating, and everybody wants to have a good time. Everybody's entitled to a good time. Please do not drink and drive. First of all, it's against the law. Second of all, here in our lovely state, if you get caught with a DWI, you're going to face some very stiff penalties. This includes mandatory jail time, mandatory fine, a couple programs I think you got to go through, AA meetings, an interlock device. Can you really afford that?
Well,
I couldn't. So I won't chance it.
Ain't worth it.
Ain't worth it. So instead of my drinking and driving, I'm going to stay home and just enjoy the festivities.
Yep.
After, of course, I get off work, you know, that goes without saying. I'm just going to enjoy the festivities and just have fun. Hang out with my buddy, you know, and maybe Facebook a little. I don't know. So I just want to give you that reminder. Please, don't drink and drive.
Don't drink and drive.
Don't drink any alcohol, please. If you must drink, make sure you stay at home. Either that or drink plenty of water. Everybody needs fluids here.
And have somebody drive you home.